everyone, and welcome to an episode that is not really a podcast style episode at all. I'm Duncan, and with me as always is my friend Momo.
Yes, hello everybody. We really wanted to talk a little bit maybe about how it would be to make Malazan TV show, what would be problems, what would be great things. And, you know, we will speak about this knowing fully well that I don't think we will get this TV show anytime soon. But anyway, we really wanna talk about this. I think it will be fun for us.
So basically what we wanna talk about here is pros and cons of making Malazan into a TV show, because there are pros and there are of course always cons. Nothing is ever perfect.
Thing is, I'm not sure that technology is ready to adapt this right now, for example.
That is one of the hurdles, one of the biggest probably.
I was scrolling through Reddit, and there are a lot of people, and I kind of agree with them. They think that, you know, maybe animated TV show would be better. But, you know, animated TV shows or animated movies are not even close to popularity of normal movies and normal TV shows. So I don't think that would kind of work. I really want to see this, like, in live action. That's my point.
Well, that's another thing where you can wait it a little bit. For example, do you want more people to see this? Do you want to expose Malazan to more people? And I'd say sure, why not?
My answer is yes, and I think for that reason alone, I think live action TV show would be best. I was never a fan. Another option, you know, possibility is obviously movie, but I was never a fan of adapting books into the movies, because I don't think you can really do it. I think only example where it was done, like, very nicely was in case of, for me, Lord of the Rings.
But let's be honest here, Lord of the Rings is trilogy.
Yes.
It's shorter books.
Yes. Basically, you know, we will focus on TV show. I think that is the best media, you know, to adapt Malazan, in my opinion, of course.
To be honest, I wasn't even focusing on TV show. I was just, we will here present how we would like that our characters look. And we picked some actors. And that will come a little bit later.
Yes, but before, you know, we even start, I just want to tell everybody that we understand fully well, if this ever become TV show, they will need to find mostly unknown actors. But, you know, it wouldn't be fun to make a casting list with some unknown actors.
How can you even find them?
So we focus on how we imagine, like, how characters look like and what famous actor kind of fit best.
It's, imagine it, guys, we are doing this for fun. Nothing serious.
Basically.
It's just relaxed, me and Momo trying to show how do we imagine bridge burners, how do we imagine, you know, all these epic characters. But I just want to say, for example, for me personally, why I would love to see, for example, Malazan being translated into a TV series. For example, nobody in my family, or even friends except for Momo, reads. People simply don't read. So how can I share my passion of Malazan with them? And for example, I remember also I was reading Game of Thrones before, and people were not reading. That's simply how it is. Some people don't read. But you still want to share your passions.
First of all, Game of Thrones was very popular as a book. But it was nowhere near the close of popularity that is right now after that TV show. Now everybody know about it. I want that same for Malazan.
Yes, but,
and I think that Malazan deserves it. For me, it's better than Game of Thrones.
But do you know why there is also a negative side to this? I was thinking about it. For example, do you know when was the last book that was written in Song of Ice and Fire?
I don't think that is only because of...
But do you remember? Do you know when was the last time?
Yes, it was long time. But Martin was always slow.
It was in 2011, man. There is slow and then there is not writing at all. Martin is not writing at all, man.
I really agree with that. I think he is, like, living a life. He is in center of attention right now. he have money to throw around.
It's not only that, man. He is on all those, when they were making Game of Thrones, he's there. He's, I don't know if he's directing, but he's simply present.
Not directing, but he's their advisor.
Yes, he's guiding everything. And that's good, because, you know, he made the show better. Even though they are changes, but those changes are simply to keep story spoiler-free.
But here is my point. Even when he was writing the fastest in his career, he was still writing like 3 times slower than Steven Erikson.
But never like this, man. 8 years for one book. I mean, it's clear to me that he changed his job.
Another great thing about Malazan is that at least main series is finished. So, you know, we will not end up in the same situation like with Game of Thrones, where basically there is TV show running on nothing.
Yes,
there are no books behind it.
Okay, but what about Karkana's trilogy? What about new Karsa trilogy? Do you think those would not suffer if he started now having the second job?
I think they would suffer a little bit, but it wouldn't be anywhere close to what Martin did.
So this is my question for us, you know, real fans, big fans of Malazan. Do we want show at the price of slower writing books?
Yes, in my opinion, no.
It's questionable,
for
right?
Me,
you gotta wait.
For me, I would, you know, sacrifice little bit of speed of Erikson to get more people interested in this. Man, but I'm that type of guy. When I find something that I truly enjoy, I wanna like share it to everybody. I want everybody to read Malazan. And when I see, even to my friends who are reading, when I say, oh man, this is great, you need to read it, and they say, oh, okay, how big it is, and I say, man, it's 10 huge books, and they are like,
yes, that's what I hate too, man. I cannot get anybody to read this book around me. Nobody. I mean, I cannot get anybody near me to read anything, to be honest, but still, it's frustrating. But if you give them some show, okay, they might come a little bit.
Of course, man, because show, for example, you can chew through one season in probably a day. And you can, you know, relax your brain, because it's different. For example, when you are reading, and you are reading, for example, about Quick Ben, first you need to work hard and read how he looks. Then you need to try to visualize him in your head. But when you are watching TV show, he just appear, you see him, okay, that's Quick Ben. It's over. 1 second.
Yeah, but
I'm
still
when you are
reading,
that is process.
To me, you know, I will always pick reading, no matter what.
I agree with you 100%, but most people will not do that.
But there is another option that is, in my opinion, the worst. And that's what they did to, for example, Walking Dead. And I don't know if you are familiar with what they did there.
Oh, man, there is you probably never heard about, for example, Sword of Shannara. They adapted that to TV show, and it was terrible, terrible, terrible.
Why was it terrible?
Man, because, you know, it was simply terrible. I cannot... I didn't read book. I heard that books are good. But I watched, like, almost entire first season of that TV show. But I watched it, and I swear I cried while I was watching it. It was how bad it was to me.
Man, the reason why Walking Dead is, for example, in my opinion, one of the biggest... You know, the show is still popular, but what happened to it, and this would not be acceptable in Malazan, they changed so much because it's adapted from comics. And this guy that sold rights, he sold rights completely, and he's not involved in show at all. So that is, in my opinion, if Erikson would do that... And, you know, not do it like Martin, where he kind of overlooked the project. That would be a terrible mistake. He would, for example, they would kill major character who is still in comics, very important, they would kill it, just to create some shock effect.
Yes, I know. But I really hope that it won't happen. But, you know, one huge, like, thing for Malazan, for future of Malazan TV show, will be this upcoming Wheel of Time TV show. If those guys butcher it, I really think, or if they don't butcher it, but it's not like, it's not popular, I think that will not help Malazan, you know, speed its adaptation to live action.
I hope it will be, everything will be fine.
Yeah, but I really think that it depends a lot if this upcoming Wheel of Time TV show is like huge, huge success. I think we will, be one step closer to Malazan TV show.
I guess. But shall we now start with what we really came here to do?
First, I wanna little bit say how, why, for example, I don't think that today technology is not ready for Malazan TV show.
Okay, sure.
I don't know if you remember when Game of Thrones first came out.
Of course, I remember.
That they burned like good chunk, I'm not sure exactly what percentage, but good chunk of their first season budget on those three small dragons.
I remember.
Who did nothing. And here, man, in this book, you have at one point five grown-ass dragons fighting.
And with all kind of magics.
Yes, but that is another thing. I'm just speaking about, imagine five huge-ass dragons, then Anomander turn into dragon, then that Lord of Galain turn into dragon. You know how expensive that would be, man. And another problem is, while, for example, Game of Thrones is fantasy, it's very light on magic. If you remember what in first, like, five seasons, before White Walkers, what was the fantasy element there?
Pretty couple much nothing.
Couple of times that Melisandre used some magic and couple of dragons show. But here, man, everything is about magic. And you know how expensive that is, to make to look decent. You can make with CGI too, but generally it would look bad. To make it look good, you would need some major money. And again, I'm curious to see how Wheel of Time will solve this problem. Because, that will give us a little bit of insight into how Malazan might wrestle with this. And another problem that I see is, cast of Malazan is too damn huge.
Oh yeah, there are so many characters.
Like, in Wheel of Time, you have many characters, but you can safely cut, like, 70% of them and, not lose anything, too much, really, from the story. But here, first of all, in this universe, first of all, you don't have anybody who you can say, okay, this is main character. That is the first problem. And second problem, I think, for viewers would be, for example, you are watching first season, and you are watching there is Quick Band, there is Callum, there is Fiddler, Whiskey, Jack, and you start liking those guys, there is Paran, and then second season, there is nobody of those guys, except Callum and Fiddler and Crocus.
They are gone.
It's completely new cast of characters, and after that, when that season finish, You are going to some old characters, some new, but every book basically introduce new cast of characters.
Imagine book 5, season 5.
I was thinking about it. Imagine, for example, you are watching 4 seasons of Malazan, you didn't read book. And then 5th season start, and you are like, did I miss season?
Yeah.
What happened? Because, you guys remember, and I remember when I was reading book 5, I swear to you, after 50 pages, I was like, okay, is there some book in that I missed? I don't know any of these guys. This is not the same continent. And I really think that would be, really challenging for to adapt. And, people wouldn't like it, I think.
So, do you want the show or do you not want the show?
I want the show, but it will be very, very hard to make. That's what I'm saying.
So we want it, but we want it done right.
Yes. And can you, for example, imagine, also in Game of Thrones, for example, there were not many battles. Those battles are extremely expensive to make. But can you imagine, for example, in Book 2, entire season is one long protracted war, man.
But just imagine Siege of Pale. I think we never saw such a huge scale fight.
Yes, okay, but that is like one episode. But can you imagine book two, man? Entire book two is one huge ass army fighting pretty much entire book. That would cost so much to make.
Yeah, but we can hope, I guess.
Yeah, we can, you know, but these things that I just said now are things that worry me the most. Or, for example, how could you know, make a change, Amale?
Oh, yeah. Jagut.
Or foreclose sale?
Yeah.
Those are all things that, man, cost money. This TV show, I think, would need to have budget of like 15 millions per season to make it at least look passable. And you know, in my opinion, what is the last problem of it?
What?
I really think that this is more like for a little bit older audience.
I
It's
think it is. I think that's true.
like, for example, you know, even Game of Thrones is, you know, there are boobs everywhere, there is fucking, but I'm not speaking about that. I'm speaking about you need to think in Malazan.
You are correct. I think that is the worst obstacle.
Yeah.
Because you really need some intelligence to be able to follow Malazan. That's.
I agree.
Yeah. But that will not stop us, guys. We are gonna share now with you. So, this is not our cast. This is just how we imagine characters, how they look. And it's just for fun. So, don't take
No,
this as anything
it's basically,
serious.
for example, how I imagine character, and then I, you know, scroll through, I don't know, everywhere to try to find what famous actor or actress fits them the best. And in some cases, I failed. And in some cases, for example, for somebody who was supposed to be brown, I couldn't find anybody that fit, I don't know, some other aspect, so I put some white dude.
Yes, but you know,
So,
it's closer to what you imagine. I get
yes.
it.
So, you know, be gentle with us here. I know that usually these types of things get a lot of hate. Just, you know, think of it as a fun exercise in imagination.
Yes, this is just fun. And I'm also interested in our community. How do you imagine, guys, these, you know,
Yes.
favorite characters? And these are, just remember, this is Gardens of the Moon edition. And even there, of course, we couldn't put all 95 characters from the dramatis personae. We selected some, maybe, I don't know,
Yes.
20 maximum.
Something like that.
So,
But here is my first man.
is it Callum?
Callum. Can you
Okay,
see?
I see him, and that is the same, the person that I picked. So
Man, I
let me
see it
show you.
too. When I was long time ago, I was reading something on Malazan, you know, and there was thread about caste, and
Let's
when I
give
saw
his name
Idris,
first, man. This gentleman's name is Idris Elba.
when I saw him, I was like, oh, this guy is Callum 100%.
He just need a little bit longer hair and he would be perfect.
Yes, but you can add that easily. But man, this guy is perfect. He have that lumbering quality to him. He's a little bit bigger.
He has wide shoulders and he has that serious face to him.
Yes. And you know, he's really, this is also very good actor. He's like deep and he's similar age to how I feel Callum is, because Callum is like little bit older too.
He is entering into veteran ages.
Yes. But you know, this is like safe pick. I think that most people would choose this guy to play Callum.
Well, from what we were reading, you know, fantasy cast in forums, in Reddit, everywhere, majority of people select this guy for Callum. So I think this was safe pick.
But what about Quick Ben?
Oh
Look at
my
this.
God, who the hell is this?
Man, his name is Peter Mensah or something like that. And man, this is exactly how I picture Quick Ben.
This is my. I again went with the safe pick.
Yes, man, but I, to be honest, Lance Reddick, the guy you choose, was my pick before I saw Peter Menes. Mensah or whatever his name is. Look at this face, man. Look at this intensity.
I'm very, you know, I'm not sure if your pick is better than mine because, guys, we don't know. I don't know what Momo picked. We are just now sending each other pictures. So this is the first time I saw his pick, and really, this guy has something quick banished to him. This
man,
Peter.
Quick Ben need to be like willowy and thin, almost like you can feel that you can break him by looking at him.
But Lance is also willowy thin.
Not like this guy, man. Oh, by the way, this guy is buffed also, but you know you cannot see
who,
it.
Who here. Is buffed?
My guy that I choose.
But
Peter
we don't want buff.
I know, but you know he will be dressed.
Okay.
But look at this man's face. Look at these cheeks, how they are kinda inward.
Okay, maybe you convinced me that this guy would possibly be better. But I like Lance also. He's good.
I kinda see him as Quick Ben too, but you know, I prefer my pick here really, really little bit more.
You guys can tell us what you feel. Okay,
okay, so we move to Whiskey Jack. And you know, for Whiskey Jack, I wanted somebody like solid.
Oh my god, what the hell is that?
Little bit older. And, oh man, no. Okay, I choose Russell Crowe.
Man, tell me Duncan, that my guy is not better.
And Duncan choose guy from Walking Dead.
Andrew Lincoln.
Man, he doesn't have that commanding presence
as
Russell Crowe has.
Look at the face of that guy. Look at his beard is wrong. This guy look like a truck driver to me.
Exactly, but Russell Crowe, for you know who else would be good in my opinion?
Who?
For example, somebody like Liam Neeson.
I don't know, man. Whiskey Jack but needs the beard. He needs to be... I think I have never seen Liam with beard.
But this picture of Russell Crowe, this that I used to show you, come on. Tell me that this isn't Whiskey Jack.
To me, it's not even close, man. That's not how I didn't imagine him like buffed guy. I imagined him to be lean, strong. But not buffed.
Oh, so you don't agree with Russell Crowe?
No. To me, this Andrew
Lincoln
is much better.
I just imagine he will not wear this. He wear armor.
Man, it doesn't matter. He simply looks too buff. Too.
Man, this is Russell fucking Crowe. He can pull it off. Lose some weight, whatever.
You can guys tell us which one you like. But to me, Andrew is much better Whiskey Jack.
Not even close, man. Not even.
You see, this is the issue. How can we make a
Come
show?
Come on, man. He look ridiculous. When you said, man, this guy look like truck driver, I was talking that you are meaning on your choice, honestly.
Yeah. Your guy look like a truck driver.
No.
Look
you,
at his
man. My
mustache.
Pick is better.
Okay, but you know, people can tell us. This is our whiskey. Oh, this is good. This is interesting,
okay.
But I beat you. I beat you easily.
For my fiddler pick, I choose Domhnall Gleeson.
Man, first
he's the
of
guy
all,
from he's the guy from Harry Potter. He's brother of Ron.
First of all, let me tell you something. Fiddler is warrior. Fiddler doesn't look like a little boy.
Man,
this Fiddler, is Fiddler.
Okay, show me.
This is Fiddler, man.
What's his name?
This is a gentleman named Damian Lewis.
You know why I don't agree?
Why?
Because Fiddler is supposed to be a couple of years older than Paran. And
yeah,
you put some 45-year-old
he's
guy.
He's not really a couple of years older, but man, he is aged soldier, going through fights. He's
man,
definitely not boyish looks.
Man, you can
every
know,
supper
dirt
is old in soul, man.
Man, come on, this is like 50-year-old guy.
I imagined always Fiddler, man, he was sergeant, he's, you know,
yes,
the other looks him like children. I mean, the other looks at him like his father. Who will look at your guys like he's their father?
Man, not in first season, but in 7 years, in season 7.
Come on. Come
man,
on.
This is exactly, you need somebody who is young now. You know, you will make him a little bit rougher, of course. He will not have this fancy hair and everything. But you know, he will grow old with TV show.
If people pick this guy to be Fiddler, I think I would be against making the show.
Come on, man.
Look at
him,
he's playboy, man.
You find some 50-year-old dude.
But look at him, he has that toughness.
Yes,
Fiddler has to be tough.
I agree. You know, like, in general, my picks especially are maybe a little bit too pretty to play these guys. Because, you know, these are soldiers. They are not pretty, man.
I don't know, but I really don't like your fiddler. But
Okay,
you know,
how about my...
maybe other people, you know, like it more.
We will see in comments. Okay, this is my hedge. And you know, it's not about how this guy only looks.
Okay, this is not bad.
It's not about his looks, man. This is Sam Rockwell. And you know, this guy is, like, in my opinion, one of the best actors around. And I really think he could play Hedge perfectly. Because Hedge is like, he's cynical, but you know, he likes to fuck around.
It's not only that, but I can imagine if you blasted this guy with some scars from fires and stuff,
and you know,
he could look ugly enough and pull it off.
Another thing about Hedge, he's a little bit crazy. And this guy can play crazy very good, man.
You know how I always imagined Hedge?
Okay, show
me. He was a little bit poor, he's balding. And he
Don't
has
tell
that...
me, show me, motherfucker.
Okay, I'm showing. And he has that leathery face. So this is my
man, this guy is too serious.
Well,
Mr. Friendzone. You want Mr. Friendzone to play Hedge?
I know, guys, but this is my issue with it. When I was looking for somebody for Hedge and Fiddler, they had to have that tough skin. And this guy has it. And he's kind of also balding. And that's how I imagined... Hedge.
This guy is too square.
But
to play
here's my question: does this guy have the range to act not something serious and to act somebody who's a little bit, you know, funny?
Sam Rockwell does have that range.
Well, you know, maybe this guy also have. He looks like he can pull it off. But I like your pick also. I could go with either of these guys.
Oh, guys, you know. I was hoping, to be honest, that, you know, we will, like, on every pick, be able to, you know, like, agree who is better. But apparently, man, you know, we are both stubborn. So we will need our, you know, viewers to say, okay, you are wrong, you are right.
Man, maybe viewers have somebody number three who's not at all what you or me choose.
We will see. Okay, this is my Trotz. And Trotz was a little bit hard because, you know, whoever played him, he will obviously need a lot of whatever, CGI, makeup, I don't know.
But he doesn't need much, he just needs blue paint on his face.
Blue paint and
Is this guy big?
He kinda is. He is also very, you know, fairly famous actor. And, you know,
What's
he
his
have
name?
Range to play, like, very dangerous guys. And very intense guys. And I think that's who the Trotz is. And I forgot to mention, this guy's name is Manu Bennett. He's a Deathstroke, I think.
So for Trotz, I went a little bit out of box. This is not even... Well, he is actor, but kind of actor. Ooh. This guy's name is... Because I always kind of imagined Trotz to be a little bit, you know...
Come on, you choose Big Kali. Come on.
Man.
This is Karsa, man.
I don't know.
This is how I imagine Karsa.
But Trotz is also similar to this. To me.
Oh, man. But this guy is too huge, I think, for Trotz.
Trotz is pretty big, man.
And you know, this guy is not actor. He is a fucking
man, all those
wrestler.
Wrestlers are actors.
Yes. His name is Big Kali,
I mean, right? Yes. But I mean, I love your guy too. He does have that good face. He could be Trotz.
He have intensity also, man.
But look at Kali. Look at his intensity.
And you know, difference between my guy and yours is that mine is actually not only actor, but you know, a good one at that.
Man, Trotz doesn't have to act a lot. He just smash.
Man, but now can't pick that I really hated. Because Mullet. I couldn't find for sorry, man.
What about Mullet?
Actually, I couldn't find nobody for Mullet, to be honest. So you are alone there.
Okay, guys, this is my Mullet. Don't kill me. But remember...
But you know, before you put it, Mullet need to be like big guy.
You know, this guy is definitely big, but Mullet is not big. He has a round face. There is difference. He's not huge.
Yes, but he have shoulders also.
This guy that I'm going to pick... Remember, guys, this is not casting. This guy is too old now. But to
okay,
me...
Show me.
Okay. He has that face. Look at.
Mullet need to have sad face. Come on, man. I said sad face and you show me Jack Black.
Man, thing is, this is how I kind of imagined him. There is some warmth to Mullet. He has that, he's healer. And I'm sure Jack Black would not be able to. He would never accept probably such a serious role. So this is just...
I cannot even imagine Jack
Black.
Yeah,
but like, I don't know. I couldn't find anybody who is like Mullet. This
I didn't find anybody for Mullet. And I still feel that I have better pick for Mullet.
Okay, but tell me, doesn't this kind of at least look like what you imagined for Mullet?
I cannot even imagine this, man. Okay. I cannot even imagine, I swear. Come on, Jack Black. I cannot, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, guys, but you know, that is the only person that kind of... Because in my head, Mullet looks kind of like this. So
man,
you will
I'm
have
trying
to apologize.
Be supportive, but I cannot.
But I just want to say before we go to Absalar... that I couldn't find anybody for Absalar. And here is why. I always imagined her to be this, I don't know, beauty from outside of the world. That's, you know, she to me is the prettiest girl in full book. You know, in all of the Malazan. And I was looking for actresses and I couldn't find anybody pretty enough to what I imagined. So that's the reason why there is no Absalar for me.
I had different problems. I had, like, my couple of things that Absalar, or sorry, had to tick was that she needed to be pretty, very pretty, that she needed to be young, that she needed to be Asian, and that she needed to be intense and dangerous looking.
Yes, and how can a young person look intense and dangerous?
And this is my pick, man, and it's best that I could do, and it's probably terrible.
What's her name?
It's Karen Fukuhara from Suicide Squad.
She's not bad, man. This is not terrible.
Oh, I really couldn't. The rest, you know, I googled young Asian actresses. And first of all, I was afraid that FBI will come knocking. That is the... I swear, at one point, I googled like 14-year-old beautiful Asian actress. And then I said, okay, fuck it. I will not go into this. I will not google this.
No, you know, your pick is decent.
But all of them look like harmless.
Yeah.
I need somebody who look dangerous.
This girl doesn't look bad.
And this is the best I could find.
Okay, so at least we agree at something.
Yes. Okay, for our next choice, it was Lorne. And I was thinking long and hard, but Lorne was kind of, you know, I was blanking on her. I couldn't imagine her. So, this is my pick for Lorne, man. And you will understand in second why.
Oh.
What do you think?
I don't even understand why.
Because she died, motherfucker.
Man, so many people died.
Come on, man. Come on. Sean fucking Bean.
Come on,
you always need to die in first season.
First of all, we need to understand something. She is redhead.
And Sean Bean is not redhead. You
she
cannot look put
like a blonde to me. And first,
and
second, the fool.
Okay, let me ask
he's
you.
God.
So that is the only problem you see with this. That she's redhead and I choose somebody who's not redhead. Oh, what
man.
A moron I am. I'm
man.
So sorry,
okay,
man.
Let me just say, I thought that my mullet would be worst pick. I think this is the worst pick of all times.
Come on, man. This is a great pick. Sean B, you need to be Lorne.
To me, the easiest pick was actually Lorne, because I just typed redhead actress and it listed me and I found the one that was closest to how I imagined Lorne.
Listen, let me just say now to people who are watching us. If you guys on this pick support Duncan instead of me, fuck you all. You are wrong.
But here
Sean
is the...
Bean is Lorne.
Okay, sure. This is the lady that reminded me of Lorne the most. Her name is Erin Chambers. And this is pretty much how I imagined her. It's just like generic redhead face. She is really pretty. I think she could pull it off.
I don't know, man. I still like my pick here.
You still like Sean Bean?
Of course. Just put, of course. You know, thing is, man, I'm ashamed of one thing. That, you know, he is not ginger. I fucked up there, obviously.
Okay.
But everything else is spot on. He is like you. He can even pull off that, you know, Lorne is breaking through entire book slowly but surely.
No, and I'm not questioning his range. Vulnerable. I think he could play a girl.
Sean Bean could pull that off for sure. I'm standing behind my pick 100%.
Okay, shall we go with Paran?
Oh man, Paran I didn't also find, because again, you know, I like Paran. But he's generic pretty dude. And you know, you can cast anybody in Hollywood for that, honestly.
That's true.
He just need to be young. He need to be pretty, and that's about it.
Okay, so I don't know if you will like this guy, but this is how I pretty much imagined Paran. This gentleman name is Craig Horner.
No, what's my problem? I don't dislike it. But think, man, he was another fantasy TV show that I really hated. And you know, that was made from the book that I really also hated, from the author that I really hated.
But did he make you hate it, or was it book?
Man, he was so stiff. He was terrible actor.
Okay.
You don't want this guy, trust me. I mean, he looked the part.
Man, what if this actor is listening to our podcast?
Ah, man.
You will break his heart.
Man, I'm sorry, but you know, you are a bad actor.
I don't know, but he has that Paran face to me.
He has Paran face, but I saw his acting, and you know, Paran need to be like... He's a complex character, and he's one of the most important characters in Malazan universe, in original, you know.
You know what I learned from doing this?
What?
That you and me, we should definitely not be the person who is in charge of cast.
Of course.
We definitely should not be. But shall we go with Tattersail? Which I think everybody will agree.
Listen, this is my pick, and I understand that people will shit to it. She need to be fatter, blah, blah, blah. But this is my Tattersail. It's Christina Hendricks. Look at this curvature, man.
There is no surprise. But I picked better photo.
Man, I choose this one because on my photo she look kind of little bit bigger.
Man, she can gain few pounds. But I think the point that is that she is a little bit heavier lady.
Yes.
Tattersail is heavier. She's not like fat.
Okay, we need to make like pause 5 minutes. I need to go to bathroom.
For 5 minutes?
This was joke. Come on, man.
Oh!
This was banking joke. You ruined it completely.
Man, I really thought you were going to bathroom.
I need to take care of some business. Man, but you know, she really is, for me, perfect choice for this.
I completely agree. She just need to change hair color, because I'm 100% sure that she's not
redhead. It was implied many times that, you know, people found Tattersail very attractive, even though she was a little bit on the heavier side.
This is Tattersail. It is agreed.
Yes.
I'm afraid to go with Tuck, because you will probably kill me for making this guy Tuck.
Okay, this is my Tuck.
Okay, I can see instantly that I like your guy more.
Man, you know, for this is my pick name is Paul Dano or whatever. And you know, in my opinion, Tuck need to be younger, because he's the Tuck the younger, not the Tuck the elder.
He is young. It is known how old he is, and he is young.
And second thing is, man, you know, in my opinion, he need to be a good actor. And he need to have some warmth to him. And I think this guy, I watched him a couple of movies. I think this guy checks all those things.
After your pick, I'm ashamed to even send my pick.
Okay, come on.
I struggled with Tuck, and I found the only guy that kind of looked youngish. This is my Tuck.
Come on, man. Can you imagine the... No.
Okay, guys, I agree. Momo wins.
When I see your guy, my first, like... urge is to hit him. This would be maybe good Murillo.
No, man, I have better Murillo. I mean, I have better photo of Murillo.
Oh, no, so Tuck, I clearly win.
You win. Hands down. I apologize. But anyway, this gentleman's name is Chase Crawford.
I'm sure that Dujek, I will win. And Dujek, he need to be solid. He need to be trustworthy. he need to inspire loyalty, and you need to love him, naturally. And this guy is all that.
Oh, is this the guy from the Game
of
Thrones?
On your knight from Game of Thrones, Sir Liam Cunningham.
I wanted to put him too, but I changed in the last moment.
Man, and this guy have everything that, you know, Dujek need to be, in my opinion.
He's very good. I wanted to put him.
And he's older, of course.
Yes. Thing is, my pick is, in my opinion, this guy kind of looks more like how I imagine Dujek. I imagine Dujek a little bit older than this. So this is... He is also from Game of Thrones. This is Dujek that I imagined.
Not bad, to be honest.
But they are both good. He's just... I kind of imagined him, Dujek, a little bit older.
No. To be honest, I'm stumped here. I like my pick, but I also like your.
Yeah, they are both good.
Yeah. Your is a little bit more accurate, maybe, in age.
Yeah. I think this guy can pull
it off. Here is the pick that I'm proud of. Man, Murillo, when he was first time described. What are the words that were used to describe him?
Dandy Fop.
Okay, this guy is Dandy Fop.
You know what?
His name is Joseph Gordon-Lewitt.
He's not bad. But let me just compare my picture. Okay. And this guy could clearly never play, I think, Murillo because he's now too old. But I was going with how I imagine Murillo. I don't care about cast. So this is how I imagine Murillo, completely. This is my Murillo.
That is very
good. Put a sword,
Murillo.
Put a rapier in his hand.
Yes, I agree, but you know, he might be
too... He's too old now, Orlando Bloom, of course.
Yeah, you are actually right.
That's a dandy fop, right there.
I kind of agree.
Okay, so, with Relic I had so much trouble, man. I don't know why, but I imagine Relic so cool.
Thing is, man, you know, problem about these Daru people that they are, I think, generally, like, brownish.
Yeah, right? But it doesn't have to be, like, just don't make him full pale and it's fine.
Here is my...
There is no way that guy can be.
I wasn't satisfied also, man.
First of all, Ralik has long hair.
I know him and he have that intensity of Ralik.
Okay, what is the name of him?
Riz Ahmed. But you know, to be honest, I really tried to find, because you know, I chose Murillo White and I chose Crocus White because I couldn't find. I really tried hard to find somebody brown.
I mean, you know, I wasn't really butthurt too much about it. I was just trying to... find the face
that
fit.
I was afraid
fit.
That people will hate me for being,
man,
you know,
this
for
is just fun. I hope people will not hate us. We are just having fun, guys. This is nothing official.
Come on, show. I wanna see.
Okay, I mean, I couldn't find. I'm still not satisfied with this guy. But I don't know. This is the... His name
soft.
Is Ben Barnes.
Too soft. Ralik need to be, man. When you look at him, he need to be like... You don't feel comfortable. He's like tiger.
Maybe, but this guy has that hair and he has maybe a little bit narrow face. And that's how Ralik was described.
Maybe, but you know, for me, we have kind of different approaches. You read how they look like and I read more how they feel like. Their intensity, their...
But I cannot help with what I imagined in my head. In my head, Ralik always had long hair.
I know, man. But I think, man, that my Crocus pick, you will agree 100%. Again, I say, this guy should be brown, but I couldn't find anybody brown and like naive and innocent looking. And this guy that I will show you now, his name is Logan Lerman. Man, there is like naivety in this face.
Again, this is just, maybe if he would make hair longer, then I could imagine him. Maybe.
Man, that is easy to do in...
I know, but how? I cannot imagine him with long hair. I picked the guy
with... Look
at
his face, man. Innocence. This guy is naive. He look naive.
Okay, so let me show you my Crocus. I mean, I honestly believe that this is more Crocus.
Okay, that guy... a little bit complexion, but he doesn't look as naive as my guy.
Man, he's young. He's that, you know, world is in his hands.
And look at this my guy, man. If you, for example, if you were a girl and you need to say to him, "I don't love you," would you feel sad?
Yes.
And for your guy, I would say, go fuck yourself. I don't love you anymore.
But I don't know, I always imagine, you know, the crocus like this. I don't know why, but this is how I imagined him. Ever since that first scene when he was going through roofs of Dagestan, I imagined Aladdin, I imagined Prince of Persia, and this guy screams that.
Maybe I can see that, but you know. But here for our next pick of croup, I really had a problem. Because there was one guy that always when I was reading Kruppe, he was, you know, speaking in a voice of, I don't know if you know who Stephen Fry is.
I have no idea.
But that guy is huge. So I try to find another option. And this is my option.
Oh.
This or Danny DeVito. Man, but I really would want Newman to play Krupp.
I think Newman is too big. He's like too tall. Newman is, I feel, maybe or maybe not. I cannot remember.
Bad, yes, but you can make it little bit, you know. He is short, first of all, but he's not as short as Kruppe, nor he's as fat as Krupp. But I think he could pull that, you know, smart ass annoying people like he did in Seinfeld.
Maybe, but I feel that my pick is bad. But also another thing, this guy have too good of a hair.
Ah, man, that is easy to. What did you choose? Come on, tell me, Danny DeVito,
Imagine
bro.
this guy on a mule.
Is it Danny DeVito? Oh,
His
but
name
that
is...
guy is even bigger than.
Man, come on, this guy, look at him, he's not big at all compared
Man,
to Newman.
yes, he is higher, you know, than him.
Maybe. I don't know, I didn't really research, but this is the face when I imagine
Yes,
Krupp.
slightly dumb face
And look at his
of
hair,
Krupp.
greasy. It's exactly how it's
Yeah,
described.
you know, to be honest, I really like your pick, but problem is that your guy is, you know, too tall to play it. But he
So I
had that, you
didn't.
know.
This guy is tall. I never saw him as tall.
I mean, you know, yes, he
Joe
is not,
Lovitz.
yes, not tall, but you know, Kruppe need to be basically a midget.
Man, I think that Newman is taller than John Lovitz.
I'm not sure, but you know, I kind of like your pick here even more. Man, this
Okay.
guy have that sleazy, you know,
Yes.
sleaziness of Krupp somehow.
This is group, man. Come on.
I kind of agree, man. I kind of agree. I'll give it to you here. And you know, now come pick, man. They were, you know, I spent like 2 hours trying to find somebody. And
Anomander?
I, yes, and I just said, you know, fuck it, it's impossible. I honestly think whoever play Anomander, you know, will need to be in heavy disguise. But I think that this guy, and you already choose this guy for Quick Ben, this guy have intensity to play and nobility to play Anomander.
Yeah, it's
Obviously,
possible.
he need hair and he need to be at least look a little bit taller and bigger. But he have that nobility of Anomander, I think. It's Lance Reddick.
I will agree with your pick simply because I couldn't find anything for Anomander.
It's very hard, man, to because
Anomander is
no
too
for it.
epic.
But here is another problem. Whoever play Anomander, man, you know, this color that Lance Reddick is, black color, is not how Anomander look. He need to be like Onyx black.
I know. It's too difficult.
And
So
my
I didn't
last,
even look for Anomander, to be honest.
man,
It's
it was hell. It was hell for me to, you know, try to find him.
I'm glad that it's not my job to make casting. That's all I'm
Amen.
gonna say.
I swear, the more we, you know, do this, the more I realize how terrible we are. And this is my last pick. This is Baruch, and
Yes.
I really like this actor. He's very good actor. He need to be, obviously, need to have hair. It's Jeffrey Wright.
Man, I imagined Baruch without hair.
Without hair.
Yes, that's how I imagined him. Or at least a little bit of hair.
I'm not not sure, but you know, I think this guy could play him.
So I went with somebody who's really popular. Everybody will know who this guy is. And this is roughly how I imagined Baruch. It's not the same.
Oh, Varys.
Yeah. This is something that it's similar to how
to be,
I imagined.
I think, you know, brownish.
Well, you know, he can pull it off.
He cannot, man. He's white dude. How can he change his color? can pull it off.
Man, I'm telling
you. Can Sean Bean pull off being Lord?
yes, he can. Man, I'm just telling you, you know, face structural, you know, kinda. This is how I imagined him. I don't care what skin color they are, to be honest. I mean, I would hate if they are not correct color, but I'm just presenting here how I imagined them.
I don't know, but these, you know, maybe we forgot a couple. For example, I tried to find Evitation, but I, you know, I couldn't. I surrendered. I was maybe trying even Cotillion, and I found somebody, but you know, I wasn't too sure, and Cotillion basically appeared in two scenes.
Yeah, so, simply,
and Amanas, for example, doesn't matter who play him, he will always be in shadows or whatever.
I'm afraid this episode would be like 3 hours long if we tried to put everybody.
Yes, but you know, these are kind of most important characters that we felt like.
If people like this style of episodes, we are gonna do for the next books as well. This is just Guardians of the Moon edition, so.
Yes, just, you know, support Sean Bean as Lorne and everything will be fine. but anyway, I think this is it for this episode. I hope you guys will enjoy it. If you have disagreements, please tell us. And I would appreciate if you tell who do you think made better casting choices.
Me.
It's obviously me, man. Just by virtue of having Sean Bean play Lorne, that was stroke of genius.
Okay.
But anyway, guys, I hope you will enjoy this episode. See ya next week when we start Deadhouse Gates.